Last class, we have discussed what is kinematics and what are the different constrained motions, and also we have discussed what is link and kinematic pain. Okay, in that kinematics, it deals with the mechanisms, and in the kinematics, we will discuss the displacement, velocity and acceleration of a mechanism. We are studying about the displacement, velocity and the we are studying about only the motion. We are not discussing, we are not considering the forces acting on the mechanism. That is, and in the mechanism, it transmits the motion and modifies the motion. That we have discussed in the last class. And also we have discussed constrained motions. And there are different types of constrained motions: completely constrained, successfully constrained and incompletely constrained motions. And also we have discussed what is link. Okay, link, we have discussed that link is a rigid body or a resistant body, or it is an element, basic element of a mechanism. And in that link, there are different types of links based on the number of ends. Okay, binary link, ternary link, quaternary link. And also we have discussed different what is kinematic pain and different types of kinematic pains. In that kinematic pair, pair means two. Okay, it is a joining of two links is called a kinematic pair, and having the relative motion between them, that we call it as a kinematic pair. And those kinematic pairs are classified based on the nature of contact, based on the mechanical constraint, and also based on the contact between the two links. Okay, that based on the nature of contact, they are classified as lower pair and higher pair. In that lower pair, there is a surface contact between the two links. And in the higher pair, there is a line or point contact between the two elements or the two links. And based on the mechanical constraint, they are classified as closed pair and unclosed pair. Closed pair means they are completely, one link is completely enclosed within the other link. If you want to separate those two links, we have to destroy any one of the link in a kinematic pair. That is called the closed kinematic pair. Unclosed, we can easily separate those two in the unclosed kinematic pair, or it is also called as open pair. And based on the relative motion between the links, they are classified as sliding pair, rolling pair, turning pair, helical pair and the spherical pair. Okay, in the sliding pair, there is a sliding motion between the element, two links, that we have discussed. Okay, I'll show that example. This is a sliding pair, and here is a rectangular or circular rod moving inside a hole. Rectangular rod moving inside a rectangular hole. This is a sliding pair. Turning pair. It is complete. For example, if you consider this, this is a turning pair. Or we can consider this one also. There is a shaft inside that hole. Okay, it is turning inside that. That is a turning pair. And then it is a rolling pair. And we have that ball bearing. We have considered that ball bearing. Okay, that is the rolling pair. There is a surface contact. Here there is a surface contact between the two links. And screw pair or the helical pair. Here this is a screw pair or the helical pair. This one. Okay, there are grooves on the surface. One is the hollow and other one is the solid. This is a screw. And the last one is a spherical pair. Here the example is a ball and socket. Okay, this one is a socket and this one is a ball. Okay, it is having 3 degrees of freedom. That we will degrees of freedom, we will discuss it later. Okay, now we will discuss kinematic chain. What is kinematic chain? A kinematic chain is any group of links connected together for the purpose of transmitting forces or motion. That is called the kinematic chain. Okay, the first basic element is a link. Link is a single element or a rigid body. Then kinematic pair, it is having two links. Okay, conjoining of two links, it is a pair. Then it is a more than two links. Okay, group of links, more than two links. That is called the kinematic chain. Okay, that kinematic chain is any group of links connected together for the purpose of transmitting forces or motion. That is called the kinematic chain. Okay, it may have three links, or it may have four links or five links or n number of links. Okay, but it is used to transmit the forces or the motion. Okay, that we will discuss. Here the kinematic chains are classified as locked kinematic chain, constrained kinematic chain and unconstrained kinematic chain. Okay, first we will discuss this locked kinematic chain. What is this locked kinematic chain? In this locked kinematic chain, no motion is possible. Okay, here in the locked kinematic chain, okay, I'll write the diagram of that locked kinematic chain here. Okay, this is a locked kinematic chain. Here in the Lockwood kinematic chain, okay, this Lockwood kinematic chain is having three links. Okay, this is one by three binary links. Okay, this Lockwood kinematic chain is having three binary links. Here there are link 1, 2, 3. Here 1, 2 is a one pair, 2, 3 is a another pair, and 3, 1 is a one more pair. Okay, there are three kinematic pairs in this locked kinematic chain, and here the motion is not possible in this locked kinematic chain. Okay, if the motion is not possible in the kinematic chain, that we will call it as a structure. Okay, that locked kinematic chain, we call it as a structure. Locked kinematic chain is called as structure. It will transmit only the forces, not the motion. Okay, please remember this. Locked kinematic chain, the example is a structure. Okay, here it will transmit only the forces. Okay, we have already discussed this kinematic chain. It may transmit the forces or the motion. Okay, in the locked kinematic chain, it will transmit only the forces, not the motion. Motion is not possible. It will transmit only the forces. That is called the locked kinematic chain. Okay, we have example. We have, I think you have might have seen that in the construction of buildings, okay, they are using these truss-like structures. That is the example for the locked kinematic chain. Okay, it is having a triangular shape structures. You might have seen that. That we call that as a trusses. Okay, trusses will transmit only the forces, not the motion. Like this, they are the structures like this. Okay, this will transmit only the forces, not the motion. Okay, this is the example for locked kinematic chain. Okay, locked kinematic chains are the structures. It will transmit only the forces, not the motion. Or no motion is possible in the locked kinematic chain. Then constrained kinematic chain. What is constrained kinematic chain? Constrained kinematic chain means movement of one link causes a definite predictable movement of the other link. Okay, that is called the constrained kinematic chain. In this constrained kinematic chain, if we give the input, for example, we will take this example. This is a kinematic chain or a slider crank mechanism. If we give input to this link 2, we can predict the movement of the other links. Okay, there is a particular definite movement of the other links. That we call it as a constrained kinematic chain. This is a single slider crank mechanism. We are giving input to this. If we give this, this is the input link, we can predict the movement of the other links, or it is having a definite and predictable movement of the other link. That we call it as a constrained kinematic chain. Then what is unconstrained kinematic chain? In the unconstrained kinematic chain, one link does not cause a definite predictable movement of the other link. Here, this is the example for unconstrained kinematic chain. Here, there are 5 links in this mechanism. Okay, the link 1, fixed link, 2, 3, 4, and the slider is one more link. There are 5 links in this mechanism. Okay, if we give input to this link 2, we cannot predict the movement of the other link. There is a random movement of the other links. Okay, we cannot predict the definite movement of the other links. That we call it as an unconstrained kinematic chain. Okay, that is, in the unconstrained kinematic chain, one link does not cause a definite and predictable movement of the other link. That is called an unconstrained kinematic chain. Okay, there are, we have discussed 3 types of kinematic chains. One is the locked kinematic chain. That is, in the locked kinematic chain, no motion is possible. It will transmit only the forces. The example is a stretcher or the truss elements used in the construction of buildings, etc. The constrained kinematic chain, movement of one link causes a definite predictable movement of the other link. Example we have discussed, that is a single slider crank mechanism. Then unconstrained kinematic chain. In unconstrained kinematic chain, one link does not cause a definite predictable movement of the other link. That is called the unconstrained kinematic chain. Then, here the relation between the number of links, joints and pairs. Okay, here there are some expressions. This will give you the relation between the number of links, joints and pairs. Okay, that L is equal to 2P minus 4. Here, where L is the number of links and P is the number of pairs. Then, this is the relation between the links and the joints. Okay, last class we have also discussed different types of joints. Okay, binary joint, ternary joint and quaternary joint. Okay, that this J represents the number of joints and L is the number of links. Here, L is equal to, this is a relation between the links and the joints. L is equal to 2 into J plus 2 divided by 3, where J is number of joints and L is the number of links. Then we will move on to the, after the kinematic chain, the next one is the mechanism. Okay, I already told you, this link, kinematic chain, kinematic pair, kinematic chain, they are in the order. The first is the link, then is the kinematic pair, then it is a kinematic chain, then it is a mechanism. Okay, what is a mechanism? Okay, we have briefly discussed about this mechanism in the last class. A mechanism is a constrained kinematic chain with one link fixed. It transmits and modifies a motion. That is called the mechanism. Okay, mechanism means any one of the link in a kinematic chain is fixed, then we call it as a mechanism. For example, now I'll write it here. Okay, now if I write it like this, Okay, let me write the 4-bar chain. Okay, this is a 4-bar chain or a 4-link chain. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, if I write it like this, we call this as a 4-bar chain. 4-bar chain. Okay, if I want to call this as a mechanism, any one of the link in a 4-bar chain must be fixed. Then we call it as a mechanism. Okay, I'll fix this link 1. Okay, mechanism means constrained kinematic chain. See here, it is a constrained kinematic chain with one link fixed. Okay, here the link 1 is fixed. Then we call it as a mechanism. Okay, any one of the link in a kinematic chain is fixed, then it is called as mechanism. Or it is also called as linkage. Okay, sometimes we will call it as a linkage or a mechanism. This is a 4-bar mechanism. This is 4-bar mechanism. This is called 4-bar mechanism. Please remember, mechanism means any one of the link in a kinematic chain is fixed, then we call it as a mechanism. Example, we have discussed already this slider crank mechanism. Okay, let me go back and I'll show you that. This is a slider crank mechanism. Okay, here there are 4 links in this slider crank mechanism. Link 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, the link 1 is fixed, then only we call it as a mechanism. Then we will move on to the inversion. What is an inversion? Inversion means the exchange of fixedness of a link with its mating link in a kinematic chain. That we call it as a inversion, or the process of changing different links of a kinematic chain for becoming frame is known as kinematic inversion, or exchanging the fixedness of a link with its mating link in a kinematic chain. That we call it as a inversion. Okay, let me consider again this 4-bar mechanism. Okay, here in this 4-bar mechanism, okay, let me consider this 4-bar mechanism. This is a 4-bar mechanism or 4-link mechanism. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, the link 1 is fixed in this 4-bar mechanism. We call that as a first inversion. If the link 1 is fixed, we call it as a first inversion. Then if the link 2 is fixed, okay, let me write that. Okay, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. If this link 2 is fixed, it is called a second inversion. And if link 3 is fixed, similarly, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. If link 3 is fixed, it is called third inversion. If the link 3 is called fixed, it is called third inversion. And if the link 4 is fixed, if this link 4, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. If the link 4 is fixed, it is called fourth inversion. It is called fourth inversion. Inversion means changing the fixedness of a link with its mating link in a kinematic chain. That we call it as an inversion. This is first inversion, link 1 is fixed. This is second inversion, link 2 is fixed. Third inversion, link 3 is fixed. And in the fourth inversion, the link 4 is fixed. And depends on the application, we will fix the link or we will change the fixedness of a link. Then what are the properties of these inversions? Okay, inversion. Here, number of inversions possible for a kinematic chain equals the number of links in the parent kinematic chain. Okay, if it is a 4-bar mechanism or a 4-link mechanism, the number of inversions is equal to 4. Number of inversions is equal to the number of links in the given mechanism. Okay, here there are 4 links. There are 4 inversions in this mechanism. Then, the other property of this inversion is relative motion between any two links does not change with inversion. Okay, the relative motion between the links, for example, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4 and 4, 1. The relative motion between the links, any two links does not change with inversion. This is simply because relative motion between different links is a property of the parent kinematic chain. Parent kinematic chain means this is the 4-bar mechanism. This is the parent kinematic chain. But absolute motion of points on various links that that with respect to the frame or the fixed link, absolute motion of points on various links, however, change drastically from one inversion to the other, even in direct inversion. Then what is direct inversion? A direct inversion is one in which relative link dimensions remain same in every inversion. Okay, that is called the direct inversion. The dimensions of the links will not change. The relative link dimensions remain same in all the inversion. That we call it as a direct inversion. Okay, please remember, inversion means the change of fixedness of a link with its mating link in a kinematic chain. Okay, we will discuss different types of inversions of a 4-bar mechanism, single slider crank mechanism and double slider crank mechanism later. Next, we will move on to the machine. Okay, this is the after mechanism, there is a machine. Okay, machine may have group of mechanisms. Okay, mechanism or group of mechanisms used to perform some useful work, that we call it as a machine. Okay, a single machine may have many mechanisms. Okay, that all the machines are mechanism, but all the mechanisms are not machines. Okay, the example, here lathe machine. Okay, that lathe machine may have many mechanisms and also it will do some useful work. And one more example, the IC engine. Okay, in IC engine we are using different mechanisms and it will do some particular task or the useful work. That is also the example for the machine. Next, we will move on to the degrees of freedom. What is degree of freedom? Degree of freedom is the number of independent relative motions, both translational and rotational, a pair can have. That we call it as a degree of freedom or degrees of freedom. Three translational motion and three rotational motion. Translational x, y, z, and here we will consider that theta, beta, gamma, or any three rotational motion and three in different directions, translational and rotational. Degree of freedom is equal to 6 minus number of restraints or the constraints. Always it is n minus 1. Degrees of freedom is equal to n minus 1. 6 minus number of restraints we will consider. Or degree of freedom means the number of independent coordinates required to specify the motion of a body is called the degree of freedom. Then what is mobility of mechanism? Then mobility means the number of degrees of freedom it possesses. Okay, that mechanism or the number of degrees of freedom that object or the body or mechanism possesses, that we call it as a mobility of a mechanism. Or mobility means it is ability to move in different directions. That is called the mobility of mechanisms. Then to find the mobility of the mechanisms, we are using this Grubbler's mobility equation for a planar mechanism. And this Grubbler's mobility equation will help us to find the degrees of freedom of a given mechanism. And this is F is equal to 3 into n minus 1 minus 2L minus H. Here F is the mobility or degrees of freedom. This capital F represents mobility or the degrees of freedom. And N is the number of total number of links in a mechanism. And L is the number of 1 degree of freedom joints. Or it is the number of kinematic pairs, number of pairs having a lower kinematic pair, that we call it as L. Or it is L is also equal to number of 1 degree of freedom joints. And H is the number of pairs having a 2 degree of freedom joints, that is called H. Okay, to find the mobility of the mechanism or to find the degrees of freedom of the mechanism, we will use this Grubbler's equation. F is equal to 3 into n minus 1 minus 2L minus H. Okay, using this relation, we will find the mobility of the given mechanism. And this table will help you to find the mobility of the given mechanism. And here we will consider degrees of freedom of various joints found in planar mechanism. Okay, here joint, type of joint, nature of motion and degrees of freedom. Okay, this may help you to find the number of degrees of freedom of the mechanism. Here joint, if it is a revolute or hinged joint, it is nature of motion is pure rotation and degrees of freedom is equal to 1. Next, prismatic or slider. If it is a slider or a prismatic type of joint, it is having a pure sliding. Then the degree of freedom is equal to 1. Then if it is a cam or gear, there are two nature of motion is both sliding and rolling. If both sliding and rolling, we will consider 2 degrees of freedom. Then rolling contact, here it is pure rolling, the number of degree of freedom is equal to 1. Okay, this table will help you to find the degrees of freedom of the given mechanism. Now we will consider some example of degrees of freedom. Okay, first we will consider this example. It is a 4-bar mechanism. In this 4-bar mechanism, there are 4 links. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 links in this 4-bar mechanism. And the number of kinematic pairs are 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4 and 4, 1. And here, total number of links is equal to 4. And number of kinematic pairs having a single degree of 1 degree of freedom is equal to 4. And here the number of kinematic pairs having the 2 degrees of freedom is equal to 0. Okay, here all are the turning pairs having 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4 and 4, 1. Now we have to substitute this N, L and H in this expression, mobility equation, F is equal to 3 into N minus 1 minus 2L minus H. Substitute and in this expression, we will get F is equal to 1. That means degree of freedom is equal to 1. That is, one input to any one link will result in definite motion of all the links. Okay, this number F represents one input to any one link will result definite motion to definite motion of all the links. One input is sufficient. Okay, that is this is the example for the degree of freedom. How to find the degree of freedom using the Grubbler's equation. Okay, we will consider one more example here. Okay, this is the second example. Here, first we have to count the number of links in a mechanism. Here, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 links in a mechanism. And how many numbers, N is equal to 5. Then how many number of kinematic pairs having a single degree of freedom, that is L, or having a lower pairs. Okay, this is 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5 and 5, 1. There are 5. L is equal to 5. Okay, here 5 pairs of pairs are having a single degree of freedom. And 2 degrees of freedom or the higher pairs is equal to 0. H is equal to 0. And substitute this in this mobility equation. F is equal to 3 into N minus 1 minus 2L minus H. We will get F is equal to 2. And this F is equal to 2 will represent 2 inputs to any 2 links are required to yield definite motion in all the links. In this case, there are 2 inputs are required here for input to second link and input to the 5th link. Okay, this F represents the number of inputs required to any links are required to yield the definite motion in all the links. Then we will move on to the next example here. Okay, in this example, first we have to count the number of links. Okay, here there is a slightly different than these 2 examples. In this case, both binary links and the ternary links. Okay, these are called the ternary link. This hatched portion will indicate, this entire thing we will consider it as a single link. This is a ternary link. Okay, this is 1, 2, 3. 3 ends. Okay, this is a ternary link. Okay, this entire thing we will consider it as a single link here. Okay, first let us count the number of links in this given mechanism. Okay, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, here 2 are the ternary links and others are the binary links. And how many totally, how many, okay, we are not bother about whether it is a binary link or ternary link or the quaternary link, but we will consider the total number of links in the mechanism. Here, N, total number of links in the mechanism, N is equal to 6. And this L is equal to the number of kinematic pairs having a single degree of freedom, or it is having a lower pair. Okay, this is we have to write that 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 1. Then we have to consider this 3, 5, 5, 6 and 6, 1. Okay, there are 7 kinematic pairs having a single degree of freedom. And 2 degrees of freedom or the higher pairs is equal to 0. Now we have to substitute all these N, L and H in this mobility equation or the Grubbler's criteria or the Grubbler's equation to find the mobility of the mechanism. Okay, we will get F is equal to 1. That means Here, one input to any one link will result in definite motion of all the links. Like this, we can find the mobility of the mechanism or the degrees of freedom of the given mechanism. These are the some of the examples. Okay, next we will discuss one more example. Here, in this diagram, this entire thing we will consider it as a single link. This is this one, we will consider it as a single link, and this is one link, and here this is the another link, and this one is the fixed link. Okay, this entire thing we will consider it as a fixed link. Now we have to find the degree of freedom of the mechanism. Now in this example, first we will consider count the number of links in the mechanism. Here in this, number of links is equal to, first let me write the mobility equation or the Grubbler's criteria or the Grubbler's equation. F is equal to 3 into n minus 1 minus 2l minus h. Here the number of degrees of freedom is n is equal to number of links in the given mechanism n. First we have to write what is n, l and h. Then we have to substitute this in the Grubbler's equation. First we will count the number of links in the mechanism. Here n is equal to 4. This is 1 link, 2, 3, 4. And this entire thing we will consider it as a fixed link. Okay, 1. There are 4 links in the mechanism. Okay, let me write n is equal to 4. Then the number of kinematic pairs having a single degree of freedom. Here in this case, it is both sliding and rolling. Okay, in this case, it is both sliding and rolling. If it is welded here, only we will consider a single degree of freedom. But here, we will consider it, here they have not mentioned like it is welded or fixed. Okay, we will consider it as a 2 degrees of freedom. Okay, in the table we have discussed, okay, there is a contact, nature of contact between the cam or the gear or the roller. We will consider it both sliding and rolling. Here, number of links having a single degree of freedom, L is equal to 3. Number of links having a single degree of freedom or having a lower pair, L is equal to 3. And here H is equal to 2 degrees of freedom. Number of kinematic pairs having a 2 degrees of freedom. Here in between this, here it is mentioned it is a higher pair. In between 2 and 3, we will consider a 2 degrees of freedom, that is both sliding and rolling. Both sliding and rolling, we will consider it as a h is equal to 1. Then we have to substitute these in this expression. F is equal to 3 into 4 minus 1 minus 2 into 3 and h is equal to 1. And we have to simplify this. We will get number of degrees of freedom. Okay, let me write this. Here 4 minus 1, 3. Minus 6 minus 1. 9 minus 7 is equal to 2. Okay, here F is equal to 3. Like this, we have to find the number of degrees of freedom of the given mechanism.